My name is Professor Martin Widschwendter. I am the head of the Women's Cancer Department at the University College London, and I am a consultant gynecological oncology surgeon at the University College London Hospital. 43% of all cancers in women are specific to women: breast, ovarian, endometrial, and cervical cancer. Over the past three decades, mortality from cervical cancer has dramatically been reduced. This success is largely due to the impact of cervical cancer screening, which has been implemented in the last 20 years. Similarly, breast cancer screening, as well as novel treatment in breast cancer, has reduced the mortality from breast cancer substantially. Unfortunately, none of this is true for ovarian cancer. Over the past three decades, despite massive effort, the survival rates have been very, very low, and the five-year survival rates are still around 35 to 42%. We as a Women's Cancer Department feel that we need to tackle four specific aspects. First, we need to understand why these cancers develop. Second, we need to be able to identify new ways to predict the risk to develop those cancers, in order then to, three, be able to prevent specifically cancer development, and fourth, for those women where we are not able to prevent the disease, at least be able to early detect the cancer. Our department has a long-standing track record of tackling these aspects. In particular, we run the largest randomized clinical trial which has ever been performed, UK CTOX, to early detect ovarian cancer, with the overall goal to reduce mortality from ovarian cancer. We are one of the largest clinical centers for gynecological cancer here in North and North Central London, with a catchment area of about 2.5 million. We are in the process of developing much large clinical trials and programs to understand why these cancers develop, to prevent those cancers, in particular in women who are genetically high risk to develop these cancers, and then to be able to predict cancer development also in those women who are not at genetically high risk. The effects of cancer are profound for each individual person who is diagnosed with cancer. However, the consequences of cancer affect everyone, and this is why our department is so keen to really make an impact and a change in the field of women's cancer.